in a little the book from the Gospel according to Luke. The Gospel according to Luke. And the chapter is number 4. The Gospel according to Luke, the 4th chapter. Verses that were read have already been articulated. We will not go back and reread all of them. But I would like for us to look very closely at verse number 32 through 35. Luke chapter 4, verses 32 through 35. Okay, make that 36. And I promise you, we won't hold you too long. Luke 4, 32 through 36. We have it, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's read this together, family. The Bible, the Word of God reads, "They were astonished at his doctrine, for his word was with power." Now underscore that. Underscore that right there. That by itself will preach. "They were astonished at his doctrine, for his word was with power." All right, verse number 33. "And in the synagogue there was a man which had the spirit of an unclean devil, cried out in a loud voice, saying, 'Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? I know thee who thou art, the Holy One of God.' And Jesus rebuked him, saying, 'Hold thy peace and come out of him.' When the devil had thrown him in the midst, he came out of him and hurt him not. And they were all amazed and spake among themselves, saying, 'What a word is this? For with authority and power he commanded the unclean spirits.'" You want to underscore, "And they came out." Yeah, he speaks to the unclean spirits and they come running out. Find someone who looks like they happen to be here and tell them, look at what the word can do. Find another neighbor, and say, look at what the word can do. You may take your seats in the house of God. Amen. Amen. Woman, just take a look at what the word can do. The word of God is quick, powerful, and a two-edged sword. The word of God gets down between the joints and the mouth, and is a desire of the thoughts and intent of the heart. The Bible says that the word of God cannot be stopped. The Bible is absolutely clear that God's word will not return to it void. I'm thankful for the word of God, for I realize there is tremendous power in the word. The Bible says, according to John's gospel, that in the beginning was the word. Word was with God, and the word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. With him, by him were all things made. And without him was nothing made that was made. The Bible says that the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. We beheld his glory, glory of the only begotten Son of God, of grace and truth. I'm thankful, family, that we have obeyed the written word. I'm thankful, family, for God's spoken word. And I'm thankful, family, for the word which was made flesh. In every situation of the word, you're talking about Jesus. I say, everywhere you look at the word, in any kind of way you want to turn it, flip So when we talk about the word family, we're not talking about something that might get the job done. We're not talking about something that could get the job done. We're talking about something that is going to get the job done. We're talking about something that has gotten the job done. We're talking about something that is sure and fireproof and will never fail. It is the Word of God. And I'm thankful, my friends, that we have the written Word. And if we understand the living Word and we understand the spoken Word, we ought to be able to say, thank you, Jesus, for the written Word.
Amen.
Yeah, the written Word has power. It has power. Now, what Luke does, Luke provides for us three scenarios of the power of God's Word. First and foremost, in the fourth chapter of Luke's Gospel, from verses 1 through 13, the Bible shows us how that the Word has power to conquer the enemy. The Word has power to conquer your enemy. If you're going to be successful in this life, you're going to need the Word of God. It was the Word of God that Jesus, the living Word, used to defeat that old serpent, that adversary called Satan. It was the Word. Satan came to Jesus and he was ready to tempt him. And Satan was trying to throw Jesus off of God's plan. He was trying to defile the sacrifice, their sacrifice that would free us from sin and redeem mankind. Satan wanted to tamper and take the life of Jesus. And in order for Jesus to remain pure, Jesus used the Word of God. Every time Jesus was tempted, Jesus would go over and over again by saying, it is written. When you know, family, what is written, Satan has a hard time dealing with you. When you know what is written, Satan doesn't like it, because every time he tries to attack, you have the Word which is able to defeat his plan. I come today to tell somebody that it's important to know the Word, because the Word helps us to conquer, amen, our enemies. I'm so thankful for the Word. Not only does the Word help us to conquer our enemies, but the Word helps to convict the sinner. You see, it is the Word of God. When I hear the Word of God, it reminds me of how undone I am.
Amen.
And it reminds me how that I can't make it without the help of God. It reminds me that I am in need of salvation. I am in need of a Savior in the worst kind of way. Yes, it is the Word of God that James said is like holding a mirror before a man's face that will show him his inadequacies, show him his imperfection, show him his flaws, and then direct him in the path in order to make it right with God. I'm thankful for the Word, because it is the Word which tells me that I can't make it down here by myself. It is the Word that reminds me that it was the blood of Jesus that was shed on the cross of Calvary that redeemed me from my sin. Let me never graduate to the idea, the erroneous assumption, that I have done it all by myself, because it took precious blood to free me from the shackles of sin. When I read the Word, I can see that not only did Adam and Eve have a problem with sin, but ladies and gentlemen, I too have a problem with sin. I do not look down at somebody in the Bible because they stumbled in their lives, because I realize and recognize that their example is to help build my faith, to say that if they stumble and God lifted them back up, what can God do with a sinner like me? I know that if God can be with him, God can be with me. So God convicts the sinner by the Word. the man with the unclean spirit came in contact with Jesus, that there was divine power that was executed that day. I know it was divine power because there were witnesses. Amen, someone. There were witnesses who saw the change in the man. Now, I'm just thankful to know that even when I'm afflicted, even when I'm tried, even when I'm troubled, that God's word can build me up and it can help my situation. It will help my outlook. It will help my understanding. It will strengthen my faith. It will set my outlook to see that I don't need to look down. I need to look up. Because if I can look up, my help is what's up. My God is what's up. My salvation is what's up. Don't get distracted by the things in this world, because my God said that his word doesn't come back to it more. So I know that there's power in the word. I'm thankful for the word, because of what the word can do. And so God takes an extreme situation where a demonic presence has taken up residence in the life of this man. And the Bible says that God would give us to know that when Jesus came on the scene, Jesus made the difference in that man's life. And I've come to the realization in my own life that if no one else can help me, if no one else can help me out of my situation, no one else can lift my heavy burdens, I have a friend in Jesus who is able to cure all of my afflictions. When the doctors shake their head, when the church folks say that they've been praying, but I can't see a change, when I don't know where my family is, I have a friend who's sticking closer than a brother. I'm thankful for Jesus, and I'm thankful for the power of his word. Even when we die, the word still has power. For I heard John say, write unto them, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Even at that, I'm still blessed. Even when the world doesn't do it right, I'm still blessed. Even when ups become downs, I'm still blessed. Even when life begins to flatline, I'm still blessed. Even when I can't get out, because and through the power of the word of God. Amen, somebody. God's word is so powerful that, brother, the same gospel you obeyed, don't you know somebody obeyed it before you? And the same gospel they obeyed, somebody obeyed that same gospel 50 years before them. Because the word of God never loses its power. I'm so glad Peter saw ago, he said, all flesh is his grass, and the glory of man, the flower of the grass. But it is the grass withereth, and the flower will fall away. But Peter was going to stand, but the word of God shall stand forever. Even at the last trump, the word of God will stand. Even when time is no more, the word of God will still stand. Even when your relationships begin to crumble, the word of God will still stand. Even when the church begins to walk away from the truth, the word of God will still stand. Even when men grow worse and worse each day, the word of God will still stand, because the word has power. The Bible says that when the apostles preached this word, when they went preaching this word in the ancient cities, Bible says that they turned the world upside down. They didn't do it because they were so smart. They didn't do it because they had it all together. They did it because they took the formula of God. And the formula of God to change a sinner into to a saint, to transform a sinner into a saint. God does it by his word. God wants to move a church. He's going to do it by his word. God wants to move a marriage in the right direction. He's going to do it by his word. God's going to move your life and get it back on track. Your life will get back on track when you do it by his word. Because his word has power. Amen, somebody. I'm thankful for the word. Now, if you're here tonight, you need to know that this is the word that saves even once again. All you need to do is believe the word of God, repent of your sins, confess the sweetest name on all tongues, put Christ's own baptism for the remission of your sins. When you leave here walking, encouraged, knowing that you are walking in the newness of life. Why? Because there's power in the word. Look at what the word can do. The word of God can fix fractured families. Amen, somebody. I say, I've seen it happen. I've seen the word of God fix fractured families. I've seen the word of God restore severed relationships. I've seen the word of God strengthen strained friendships. I've seen the word of God bring the church together and keep it strong because of the power is in the word. You got it. Why don't you stand? Someone come to Jesus. Say yes to the word because of what the word can do. Will you come as we sing the song of invitation? Say yes.
Without you, Lord, oh, without you.